976 Evil is a 1988 horror film directed by Robert Englund and starring Stephen Geoffreys, Patrick O'Brien, Sandy Dennis, Jim Metzler, Leslie Dean, and Robert Picardo. The title of this film dates it even before you press play. The film opens with this guy, who's wearing weightlifting gloves for some fucking reason. Yeah, back then, long distance fees were a real burn. $1.99 is a great deal for an all-night movie marathon. This is why the theater industry pushed to go to automated digital theaters. Spike is deep into the game and oh shit, he lost. Did someone bet a porn mag? Meanwhile, Hoax is at home with his holy roller mother. He's reading National Geographic, so we know where this shit is going.
What are you looking at? Now, you know when you get your eyeballs popped back into your head, boy.
After losing his elementary school porn, Hoax goes upstairs and invades his cousin Spike's privacy. And what's with that name, Hoax? Is he gonna go hack into computers and shit? While chilling, Spike finds a flyer about getting his horoscope from 976 Evil. I guess I should take a moment right now and let the younger viewers out there know that 976 was a popular prefix for these pay by call by minute numbers. They were usually horoscopes or betting scores or phone sex. Hey, it was before the internet. Don't judge my fucking generation.
Financial debts linger, but not for long. You have the urge to take risks. Don't be afraid. Your prize lies only a short distance away. Claim it.
Then Spike robs his aunt. I guess that horoscope was correct. We get a rehash of Spike's past courtesy of Aunt Lucy, and then it starts raining fish, causing the aunt to lose her shit.
Oh, holy son of God! These are God's fishes!
The flying fish causes Marty to show up from some magazine, and Hoax is being picked on by Marcus and his pals, who are also Spike's poker buddies. Spike arrives to save the day, leading to Hoax later discussing their new biker gang in front of Spike's girlfriend, Susie. The fact that Hoax is on a motor scooter means we are going to see every nerd stereotype imaginable in this film. Jesus. So we start following this person who walks by a phone store. Before AT&T and Verizon stores, where you sat there for 4 hours not getting any assistance. Kind of like them shipping you a fucking phone! The same thing happens, though, because the phone store ends up murdering customers. Then we find Marty at a diner, and luckily Spike is stopping by the bike shop across the street. How in the hell would Marty know that Spike was going there? Spike makes another horoscope call and goes to steal the gloves he was drilling over, but decides against it.
Hello.
A real man has the nerves to take what he deserves.
What is this bullshit?
A real man has the nerves
Fuck
to...
you.
That was a nice call. Spike almost gets splattered and he accompanies Marty in the diner. Don't worry. We will learn absolutely nothing from this scene. We go straight to Spike picking up his lady and then they get it on. As Hoax watches. They exchange underpants and then leave for the movies. Then Hoax barges in and steals Susie's panties. Nope, this guy isn't creepy at all. He also finds a horoscope flyer and makes a call that tells him he may pick up some strange if he goes to the movies. Spike has dumped Susie to play cards upstairs and she runs into Hoax out front. They end up going to a local pizzeria where they probably waited an hour and a half for their food because it was a really busy night and orders get mixed up and misplaced and generally fucked up because we can't handle our business. Then we get an awkward date poker montage.
This was taken right before I got kicked out of Catholic school.
Hey, you know, you should see the one I have at home, a gray hermit. Now there's a poisonous spider for you.
Foreshadowing! Marcus and the poor boy show up and harass Hoax, revealing the panties he stole early in the night and ruining everything.
Whose ones are these, huh?
Mine.
Get up.
You bitch.
I thought you were different.
And that is how a wonderful evening ends. Hoax then calls the number, then calls it again while Susie is making a TV dinner. Damn, this devil worship escalated quickly.
We're gonna scare the shit out of her.
Her? I think the only reason she's pissed off is because you had her fucking panties in your back pocket. So did he get the directions to build an altar to Satan over the phone? That is a cluttered drawer. Dinner is served, yet Hoax doesn't want it to happen, and oh shit, she's dead. Swanson is going to get their ass sued for that one. Aunt Jenny is pissed because somebody has been racking up 976 calls, but Hoax throws Spike under the bus. She then calls bullshit and takes his phone. Marty stops by the school.
Yeah, Marty Palmer, PI.
But your ID says police department. And wants to talk to Spike, but Hoax just happens to hear what the down low is and lets Spike in on the action. Things escalate and Hoax admits that he killed Susie, but bullshits Spike and says that she was banging Marcus behind his back. Spike then retaliates the bullshit call, and I have to wonder what is up with the lighting in this locker room. Marty finds a 976 evil number and traces it to a local phone service, and that the number was fully automated at one time, but has been defunct for months.
I guess nobody's interested in the underworld anymore, you know, just Ewoks and E.T. and football and phone sex.
Ewoks and E.T. means that this script has been floating around Hollywood for at least 4 years before production. Now we know what one of the Bobs did before becoming a consultant at Inatech. Hoax goes to the bathroom and must have put his gloves back on again. I wouldn't touch that floor with bare hands, pal. Hoax gets bullied but gets demonish and slashes the competition, delivering a warning.
Don't ever touch me again.
Spike snoops around, but then...
Hello. Hello.
What did you think you'd find, Spike?
Raining fish?
Some say it's a warning from God.
So we introduce the character of Miss Martinez with 30 minutes left in the film so that we have someone for Marty to describe the plot to. Thanks, movie. Or not, because we're back home and Hoax takes his phone back.
I gave you an order, boy. Now, won't you put that phone back?
If you value your life, I suggest you leave me alone.
Whoa. And we're back at the phone bank, and let's be honest, most people call these numbers at night, so this is totally unbelievable. Marty is in the room when Hoax calls. Spike calls, but gets a busy signal, and Marty only hears the Hoax half of the conversation. Marty splits, gets a call, and...
Hello?
You're too late, Palmer.
Hoax heads to the movie theater as Spike stops by Susie's service.
Sorry, the service was over a couple hours ago, son.
That means this scene was totally useless. We get a strip tease, but Hoax barges in with an organ in each hand.
That's dead man's hand.
This guy is calm for being in a room aflame and missing a hand. Then we get a cutaway impalement. We then get the toilet stall stalking cliche. He's not even looking. You know, for such a scuzzy bathroom, toilet paper is well stocked. He kills his mom and Marty and Miss Martinez show up. Marty does the obligatory sweep of the area and decides to climb this trellis. Dumbass. Miss Martinez then goes in the house because why the hell not? I told you not to leave the fridge open! She's lured upstairs by cries from Hoax to discover the cat's having a bit of fancy feast. Spike shows up and he joins Marty in going to save Miss Martinez as the house goes full demon motif. Spike shoots at Hoax, which is stupid, and they fight.
Guess what, cousin? Hell finally froze over.
Laser loogies? Meanwhile, in front of a projection screen, Spike reaches Hoax by talking about raping and pillaging the land, throwing him out the window, into a pit, into hell. Oh, and it turns out Robert Picardo was the bad guy. But don't worry, that will have nothing to do with the sequel, which we unfortunately have to watch. The premise for 976 Evil is actually pretty good and innovative for 1988. The problem with this film is it's poorly executed, and this sort of premise has been done much better in the decades since its release. The film is a mess of jumping around, and all the characters are useless other than Hoax and Spike. We never really find out what the hell Marty wants in the first place. It's not really cohesive, and the plot points tend to jump around way too much. Plus, if you were born after the year 2000, the whole concept will probably need to be explained to you.
Father Riley, I didn't know you could do that with an icon.